Welcome everyone to issue number 2 of COMIC CON CARNE.
That's right, we've got a packed show for you today, including a giveaway, but first we go to the pull list.
After we hit TV and movie news, DC gets a facelift again, guys, plus a major announcement that ends years of rumor and speculation. The latest headlines including Marvel, IDW, Dark Horse, Hermes Press, and more. Plus Darryl Woods will be along to give us some ink tips. And that giveaway we mentioned? That's right around the corner.
First, we go to the movies. The Dark Knight Rises. Hot Wheels is making remote-controlled bat vehicles. According to the website wirelessgoodness.com, on January 18th, the toy company filed paperwork with the Federal Communications Commission because there's a radio signal involved. And we get a look at the schematics. More importantly, we get the official name of the Batwing. It's not the Batwing. It is simply called the Bat.
Holy simplicity, co-host.
Yes, and it doesn't fly. It goes on wheels, on the ground.
If you're looking for the superhero squad and aren't finding it on the usual channel, that's because they moved, guys. The Hub Television Network has this show weekdays at 4 p.m. Eastern. Check your listings.
Green Arrow gets a green light. Deadline is reporting that the CW has given an order for the pilot featuring the Emerald Archer, simply called Arrow. It's a modern retelling of the Green Arrow story written by Warehouse 13's Andrew Kreisberg and Mark Guggenheim from a story by Guggenheim and producer Greg Berlanti. Justin Hartley is not attached to the project, which is a good thing because that would mean Smallville baggage, and we don't want that.
One show you won't find anywhere yet still is Powers, FX Channel's adaptation of the graphic novel starring Jason Patrick and the T-Mobile girl has gone back to rewrites, which are extensive enough that it's going to involve major reshoots. Powers writer Brian Michael Bendis says that's not necessarily a bad thing. That's the way Sons of Anarchy got on the air.
And you heard about the new DC animated feature, Justice League Doom. Vandal Savage puts together a new Legion of Doom, and they use Batman's super secret files to take down members of the Justice League. That's coming out on the 28th. And you know, I think we ought to do something with that.
Like what, Jason?
How about we give away copies before it hits the street? We're going to tell you how you can win your copy later on in the show. Stay tuned.
Cool.
And now the news. Team New York is watching DC.
After months and years even of rumors, Watchmen prequels are coming out from DC Comics, apparently before the summer even begins. It's a whole bunch of miniseries exploring the backstories of what happened to these characters before Watchmen, which is what DC Comics is calling their big, big maxi series. The writers and artists on each title, and each title are... on Rorschach, Brian Azzarello and Lee Bermejo. On Minutemen, it'll be written and drawn by Darwin Cook. On Comedian, Brian Azzarello and J.G. Jones. On Dr. Manhattan, J. Michael Starezinski and Adam Hughes. On Night Owl, J. Michael Starezinski and Andy and Joe Kubert. On Ozymandias, Len Wein and Jay Lee. On Silk Spectre, Darwin Cook is the writer and Amanda Connor is the artist. Now, this is a very, very interesting list. As you may know, Len Wein was the editor for the original Watchmen series. And also, these are absolutely some of the best names in comic book authoring and drawing. Getting Darwin Cook is quite a coup. He's best known as being the writer and artist of DC Comics' The New Frontier. This is super interesting news. Fan reaction is very polarizing. Some people are very excited about it, and some people feel like Watchmen is a series that should not be touched. Alan Moore has been quoted, and he has said that he actually just wants the whole thing to go away. He's not going to fight it legally because he... doesn't want to go through the legal rigmarole with DC Comics' legal people, but he has said in the past he does not endorse a Watchmen prequel, sequel, or anything else. He considers the story self-contained. So, we've always got the original, but soon we're going to have a whole bunch of new stories with some now classic and legendary characters. This is Louis Perlman for Comic-Con Carne.
More DC news, a new logo. Take a look here. Now for me personally, in a word, ew. Now the logo is interactive on your handheld electronic devices. The D peels back from the C. You see something underneath. Okay, there's a big reveal. Big whoop. Now, one of our contributors, Debbie Bell, is a graphic designer, and she's sharing what she thinks on our website. You can find that at scififorme.com. One senior VP at DC says the new logo reflects the dual identity nature of the characters. Right? Okay, that's what you're going to go with. Speaking of characters, when DC launched the New 52, the new storylines featured a mysterious woman in a red hood. Many speculated this character might have something to do with the new altered timeline post-Flashpoint, but no one knew exactly who she was. Some suggested she could be the Time Trapper, but now she has a name. DC Editor-in-Chief Bob Harris wrote on the DC blog early in January, her name is Pandora. So start speculating.
DC's also going back to Earth One this year with new stories involving both Superman and Batman. Fan favorites J. Michael Straczynski and Shane Davis will deliver Superman Earth One, Volume 2, featuring a revamped Parasite as the villain. Also in 2012, Batman Earth One, a contemporary retelling of the Batman origin by Jeff Johns and artist Gary Frank. Those titles will be targeting the bookstore audiences. Johns and Frank are also teaming up for The Curse of Shazam, which will reboot the Captain Marvel story with a new costume starting in March and the back pages of Justice League. It's also possible that this version of Captain Marvel, now simply called Shazam because of the legal hassle with Marvel, could live on Earth 2, which is where the Justice Society is about to make their reappearance in the New 52 Phase 2.
And Batman has more Facebook friends than you do. The page dedicated to the Caped Crusader reached over 2 million likes this month. DC uses the pages for their characters and their imprints to share their latest news all day, every day. Our Facebook page, not quite at 2 million, but we're catching up.
Getting close. Avengers vs. X-Men. The big event kicks off in April with story tie-ins around various titles in the Marvel Universe. The Phoenix Force is on course to destroy Earth, and Captain America wants to stop that from happening, of course. But you know, that whole Phoenix Cyclops thing gets the X-Men involved on the other side of the situation, and it's sure to be a big mess, but in a good comic book event way. But it won't tie in with Generation Hope because issue 17 is the last one. Writer James Asmus confirmed with comic book resources that sales on the title have been so low that it was pretty much a done deal, guys, when he came on board last summer. But he hopes to work with the characters in some way in the near future.
Marvel vs. Capcom is getting action figures. Minimates is launching 2-inch figure collections featuring heroes like Thor, Captain America, She-Hulk, and some of the biggest Capcom names, Wesker, Chun-Li, Akuma. One pack will be a Toys R Us exclusive. You can find out more about that at Marvel.com. You know Johnny Storm is back from the dead, right?
No. Oh. Is he really?
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Has been. Yes. Okay. Moving on.
Disney XD is about to launch a block of Marvel-centric programming called Marvel Universe, guys. The announcement came at the Television Critics Association conference. Centerpiece will be the new Ultimate Spider-Man series, which has Peter Parker working for S.H.I.E.L.D., along with new animated short-form series, live-action interstitials, and the return of the Avengers, Earth's Mightiest Heroes.
Yeah, I'm wondering if the live-action material could be a hint of what's to come in the Marvel TV shows.
I think so.
Maybe. And look at these. Real web shooters. Images from The Amazing Spider-Man and Ghost Rider Spirit of Vengeance at Marvel's website.
All right, let's talk numbers.
Sales stats are out from Diamond. It's a split. Marvel managed to come out on top in the dollars category with 35% over DC's 33%. But DC held on to number one in the units with nearly 40% over Marvel's 37%. Remember, these are just retail numbers, and they don't reflect same-day digital sales.
Big news out of IDW. Coming in March, a new Rocketeer anthology. Volume 2 of Rocketeer Adventures puts together such talent as Peter David, Mark Guggenheim, Sandy Plunkett, Paul Dini, Michael Golden, Walt Simonson, Louise Simonson, Chris Sprouse, and more, including the Rocketeer creator, the late Dave Stevens. Volume 2 will be 32 pages. It includes a pinup poster by Arthur Adams. And just like with the first volume, portions of the profits will go to Harry Cell Leukemia Research, which is what killed Dave Stevens. Another tie-in series, Mars Attacks. Eisner Award winners John Layman and John McCrae reimagine the cult classic trading card series. That's right. The movie was based on the Topps trading cards, which debuted in 1962, making this the 50th anniversary. Layman said, quote, "It's always been a dream of mine to destroy the Earth."
IDW has also teamed up with Wizards of the Coast for a brand new Dungeons & Dragons Forgotten Realms title written by the creator himself, Ed Greenwood, is teaming up with artists Lee Ferguson and Sal Buscema. Dungeons & Dragons Forgotten Realms out in April. Okay, say it with me. I am what I am, and that's all that I am.
How about I'll gladly pay you Tuesday for a hamburger today. Only Tuesdays are bad for me. Tuesdays are cruel to me.
Oh, that's why comics come out on Wednesday, guys. Including the brand new Popeye ongoing title starting in April from IDW, Roger Langridge's writing with art by Bruce Ozella.
You know, Popeye debuted as a comic strip in 1929. He's older than Superman.
Oh my god, that would make Popeye like 81 years old. That's really old.
Math. You get comic books and math.
Math whiz, right here. All right, IDW has also announced that they'll be making the trip across the pond for their first appearance in the UK. Chief Creative Officer and Editor-in-Chief Chris Ryle will be at the London Super Comic Convention. And besides participating in a few panels, he'll be reviewing portfolios. Guys, if you're a creative type looking to break in, here's a chance for you to connect with one of the major American publishers.
So you're getting ready to go to one of these conventions. You're taking your portfolio. Before you go, you need to know a few things, and we collect them in what we call ink tips. And this month, we get a little advice from Lucasfilm licensed caricature artist, Darryl Woods.
I am Darryl Woods, known as Darth Artist in the Star Wars community. I'm a local artist, illustrator, caricature artist, commercial artist, and I go around to different events, specifically children's events, and draw caricatures and different things pertaining to Star Wars and other pop culture icons. I would say that you go to all your conventions and look up all the main artists and get tips from them or see what they're doing. Coming out of all the comic book movies, comic book illustration, cartooning is very, very, very popular right now. And it's not too hard to get a job if you're good. But you got to let yourself be well known, gather up a large body of work, your best stuff, and just show people what you do. What I do is have a massive amount of posters where I can put your face on any character you name, like from Spider-Man to Darth Vader, from Dora to Tinkerbell to Jedis, Sith Lords, and stuff like that. And I have sponsors that give me all the my paper and everything that I have. I seen, like my job, I work for the railroad, they had a deal where they would take runaway and shelter kids to this place like 3 hours away. And I had an idea that maybe I could get on there and draw cartoons for them. And when I got on there to this train to draw cartoons and caricatures and these pop icon images for them, other people seen me do this and they wanted me at their events and stuff like that. You need to, like I say, amass your best work, be specific on what you do as far as everything from subject matter, the media you do on your paperwork, on your artwork and all that, and just put yourself out there and just show people what you do. Most artists would tell you draw something every day. That's what I do. You draw something every day, no matter how small, how big, draw something every day, and just keep going. Never give up.
If you're wondering where you can connect with a few artists and maybe some editors, here is the calendar list of events for the next couple of months.
We keep adding to our list of conventions and events, so go to scififorme.com and click the conventions tab for the latest.
Dark Horse and Nickelodeon have released Avatar: The Last Airbender. The Promise. It picks up where The Last Airbender left off. Not the movie, guys, but with some brand new adventures leading up to the Airbender sequel, Legend of Korra.
And don't forget, a brand new Conan the Barbarian kicks off this month along with two Star Wars titles, Dawn of the Jedi and Knights of the Old Republic War. Plus, from the pages of Hellboy, BPRD, Hell on Earth, The Long Death, number one is also out this month.
And the new Mass Effect video game hits the streets in March, and Dark Horse has a concept art. The art of the Mass Effect universe is out this month, with concept art and commentary by BioWare on everything. The characters, the vehicles, the weapons, even from Mass Effect 3. You can get a sneak peek at some pages over at the Dark Horse website, darkhorse.com.
Okay, before we get to the smaller presses, giveaway details. Justice League Doom is coming out on February 28th, and we've got copies to give away, and here's how you can win. You go to our main website, scififorme.com. Over on the right, there's a little box that says subscribe via email. You know what comes next, you subscribe via email and you'll be registered to win one of the copies that we've got. We've got three Blu-ray combo packs, five DVDs. Now you've got to be in the US to qualify to win. That's a rule from Warner Home Video. It's not us, guys. But we're going to draw at random winners on the 22nd of February. And we'll contact you and let you know that you've won a copy before it hits the street. Now, if you're seeing this show after the 22nd, you're out of luck, you're late, but you can still register on our site and you'll be in line to win other things because we're going to be giving away stuff all through the year.
Can I win something?
No.
Why? Oh, but you can win something.
That's right.
Last month we told you that Dynamite was launching the Bionic Woman in March. Issue number one has Jamie Summers in Paris tracking down surgeons who have been killing off bionic prototypes to scavenge spare parts for billionaire patients.
Well, at least it's the blonde Jamie Summers and not what NBC tried to
pass off.
And you remember that short Voltron fan film featuring Timothy Olmetson from Psych? Well, now Dynamite is bringing back the Defender of the Universe in Voltron Year One. The new ongoing series features Space Explorer Squadron number 686. Before, there were the legendary Voltron Force. Words and plot by Brandon Thomas, doodles by Craig Cermak. And it hits comic shops in April.
Also in April, Dynamite's bringing back the Shadow Howard Chaykin's miniseries Blood and Judgment in a new trade paperback, and also in a new ongoing series penned by Garth Ennis, who did a revival of Marvel's Punisher and Vertigo's Preacher, art by Aaron Campbell.
And they can't get enough of Mars over at Dynamite. Deja Thoris and the White Apes of Mars debuts in April, with the princess and her entourage stranded in an ancient city infested with hungry white apes. Oh, no. Writer Mark Rayner says that it is the most terrifying tale in the annals of Barsoom. We'll see.
The GLAAD Media Award nominees have been announced, including a category for comic books. From Team New York, Louis Perlman and Andy Schneeflock filed this report.
The GLAAD Media Awards are given out every year for different types of media that portray GLBTQ characters and people in a positive light. And this year, the comic books that were nominated for the GLAAD Media Award are Avengers: The Children's Crusade by Alan Heinberg, Batwoman by J.H. Williams III and W. Hayden Blackman, Secret Six by Gail Simone, Veronica Presents Kevin Keller by Dan Perrin, and X Factor written by Peter David. There's a great quote we have from Peter David about getting nominated. He says, "Usually when you say it's an honor just to be nominated, that's code for prepping yourself for disappointment. But in this instance, it genuinely is an honor considering that X Factor was nominated and won last year." Usually comic book companies have a very positive response to being nominated for this award because it at least makes them appear that they're giving positive portrayals of different types of minority characters and being an inclusive company in their narratives. This year, I'm hoping that Kevin Keller will win, because that's been a great storyline. But if Batwoman wins, I will not be complaining either. But best of luck to all the nominees. The winner of the awards will be announced March 24th, so stay tuned for that information right here on Comic Con Carne.
Valiant's relaunch is coming in May. The company will kick things off with XO Manowar, an oversized number one issue by New York Times bestselling author Robert Venditti and Eisner Award-winning artist Carrie Nord. The initial run of XO Manowar included art from the likes of Marvel's Joe Quesada, Jim Shooter, Barry Windsor-Smith, and Bob Layton. Will the new creative team fill those shoes? We'll see starting in May.
Hermes Press has announced that they'll be publishing a brand new hardcover library edition of the classic Gold Key adaptations of the 1960s TV show I Spy, starring Robert Culp and Bill Cosby. Six issues have been collected, along with never-before-seen publicity material and behind-the-scenes photos.
Also from Hermes, a new collection of Buck Rogers in the 25th Century, the Sunday version of the newspaper strip that ran from 1933 to 1937. They've been restored and collected and in print for the first time. Plus, just in time to bone up before the movie comes out, Dark Shadows, best of the original series, 12 complete stories from the Gold Key adaptation of the show. Hermes Press is also where you'll find collections of Brenda Starr, Reporter, Steve Cannon, and The Phantom. You can check them out at HermesPress.com.
Now, last issue we told you that Courtney Cruppren and the Night Things was coming back in a deluxe hardcover collection for the 10th anniversary. Now, Newsarama tells us that Ted Nafee will bring back Courtney and Uncle Aloysius in a new ongoing title. Along with colorist Warren Wasinich, Nafee picks up where he left off 5 years ago, introduces a new character named Holly, and word is the guys who produced the Scott Pilgrim movie still want to make a Courtney Cruppren movie. Guillermo del Toro might even be interested in producing it. We'll have to keep an eye on that. And don't forget, The Secret Life of D.B. Cooper hits the shelves next month, and Oni Press answered some questions from Comics Alliance about Sopa e Pipa coming out against the flawed legislation. You can read the transcript at onipress.com. And just to give you a heads up, for Free Comic Book Day, they're giving you Yo Gabba Gabba. You know, with this whole Sopa Pippa thing, I think I'd prefer a Sopa Pia.
With Pippa Middleton.
That works. That's work. Okay, that's all for this issue. Done, finished, in the acid-free bag.
Make sure you connect with us by social media. Besides YouTube, you can find us on Twitter and Facebook as Sci-Fi For Me.
That's right. Share us with your friends. Inflict us on your enemies.
And don't forget, SciFiForMe.com is where you subscribe and you'll be registered to win a copy of Justice League Doom.
For everyone who's been a part of issue number 2, thanks for watching. We'll be back next month.
Bye!